32 years ago, a little girl was born to a family, a big family, the eldest granddaughter in that family. Like every child, she grew up and as everyone asks, what do you want to do? What do you want to become when you're older? They asked her. The five-year-old, she's quite witty. She's quite, you know, legendary. She answered back. She said, I'm going to become a scientist. And they said, why? Well, she's going to become, I'm going to become a scientist because my granddad has no hair on his head, and I'm going to find a medication for that. Ladies and gentlemen, that legendary child was me. So Soozana, a BSc in biomedical science, a master's in cancer biology, a PhD in ovarian cancer research, an entrepreneur, and a professional wedding photographer. Who is she? She must be like the class topper. She must be genetically smart, you know. She must be great. She must be so talented. She must be so good. Let's rewind back to when I was 5 years old again. Let's go back. When I was 5 years old, I held onto my mom's hand. She wanted to travel. She wanted to move. I held onto her hand. We moved from Sri Lanka to Singapore. Then we went from Singapore to Sri Lanka, Sri Lanka to India. Then from India, we moved to the United Kingdom, England, London. And that's where I resided in. But as soon as I got there, I went straight into school. They put me straight into school, year five. Bearing in mind, I missed 5 years of education at that point. I had no basic understanding of maths, science. Maybe I knew English, bits and bobs. But I went in there, daunted, not knowing what to do, not knowing how to behave. But this is where my life gave me something so precious. A friend. Her name was Shaney. She came into my life. She stood by me. She was full of life. She was full of color. She was an artist. She was also kind of dramatic as well, to be honest. But she was always there for me. She said, Soozana, don't worry. You can do this. You're fine. You can do this. She was always there next to me saying, you can do this. She was a close friend of mine. We were so close. We ended up going to the same secondary school, high school. And a few months later, she came up to me and she said, hey, there's something wrong with my leg. Look, it's quite big. I said, that looks massive. What's wrong? Maybe an infection. She said, yeah, perhaps. I said, maybe you need to go to the doctors and find out what's wrong with you. She said, okay, yeah, you're right. And she did. She went, she came back. I said, hey, you're looking good. What's happened? She goes, Suze, I have cancer. And I said, sorry, what? She said, I have cancer. I have osteosarcoma. I had no idea what that was. I had no idea what cancer was. I was like, oh, okay, it must be something that you can get medications to. It should be fine. You'll be all right. She said, yeah, I hope so. I hope so. So she went. She went, she got her medication, she came back. She was fine. She was fantastic. She went off again. She came back. This time she had no hair on her head. I was confused. I was like, what is going on with her? Then she went off again. She came back. She went off. She came back. She went off. And she never came back. And I'd lost her to the battle of cancer. All these years, I've had someone stand next to me and say, you can do this. And for the first time in my life, I had someone, I had no one to say that to me. And that was really daunting. I had lost her to a disease that I had never known about. And that brought in fire in me. I was like, what is this? Science is gonna save us. Something is gonna save us. I wanna do science. I wanna do medicine. I wanna become a doctor. That was my dream. But bearing in mind, I wasn't good at education. I went into high school with no basic experience of maths and English and science, as I said earlier on. But I did it. I went forward. I was walking in, I was doing all I could. But I was always 10 steps behind every other child in the room. Okay, fine. It reminded me that I really needed help. I really needed more help than I could have. So I decided to get tuition. I started to do extra classes. My family were a little disappointed in me. My friends would laugh at me. I was constantly laughed at because I just didn't know how to do basic stuff. I said, okay, that's fine. That's okay. I'm gonna get through this. I will. And I did. And I went for those classes. And there was a teacher, and he was teaching me science. And he said, let's do this. And we did. We went for that science. And he taught me something, and I learned it. And he told me to answer the question. And I tried to answer it, and I couldn't. I couldn't answer it. He looked at me, and he put the board marker on the table, slammed it on the table, put both of his hands on the table, and he looked right into my eyes. And he said, Soozana, this is not for you. You're not good at academics. I said, oh. He said, you're good at art, you are artistic, go and do something in that, pursue that, don't pursue science, it's not for you. It shocked me, a teacher's telling me that I'm not good at something and I shouldn't do it, even though I loved it so much. Okay, fair enough, that's okay. I stood there questioning myself, I stood there thinking, okay, you're right, I'm not good at this, maybe I should let it go, maybe for 5 minutes. But then I thought, you know what, forget it, I'm gonna start again. And I did. I decided that I would go back and pursue my dream, which is science, and I did. Most children, when they finish high school, they go to A-levels, they go to higher education. Most of them would do single biology, single chemistry, single physics, single maths, to do medicine, of course. But I couldn't get into any of those, because I was not good at any of those. But there was something for me. There was something for people like me, and it was called applied science. So I got into that. I managed to get into that, and I did. But guess what, guys? You would not believe. When I finished my exams in applied science, I failed again. As I did all the time. My dream of becoming a doctor flew out the window. My dream of wanting to save lives just came out of me. And every university that I applied for, out of 10, it was reject, 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 reject. Oh, hold on. One university. While all the universities out of the 10 wanted your grades, one of them was like, you don't have the grades, you have the points. You did really well in your art, and your total points come out really well. And I said, okay. They were like, we'll give you an opportunity. And I'm so thankful for that. I really am. I got into my first degree, which is the biomedical science degree. I walked in, superior, very superior. You know when you walk into the first day into your university, you feel great, you feel like a superhero. You're like, new shoes, new bag, new clothes, new life. You walk in and you're like, yes. And I did, I walked in like, this is it. Then I did my exams and I did my coursework and I was like, no, 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 this is not it, no. I'm not a superhero anymore. Because again, I was failing. I was getting bad grades. I was failing. Friends were nourishing. They were going high and high and high. And there was me. It was just going low and low and low. I loved science so much. I loved genetics so much that I taught my friends how to do it. I taught my friends, this is how you do it, this is how you do it, this is how you do it. They would go to the exam. They would pass with flying colors. I would fail. What I used to do is, I used to come out of the exam, I'd go straight into the toilet, with a big smile, of course, sit in the toilet and cry. I used to cry for like 5 minutes, just 5 minutes. Then I'd walk out again, I'm like, I'm doing this again. And no matter how many times I went and I failed, I would go back to the bathroom, cry for 5 minutes, and I would walk out again saying, let's restart. Doesn't matter, let's restart. And I did. Somehow, I got to my final year of my degree, and this is where you get to choose your project. My bus is late. I run into my professor's office late. And this is the first time I'm meeting my professor. His name was Professor Helmut Mochtahidi. I walked in, and he was like, you're late. And I was like, yeah, sorry. And he was like, there's only one title left for you. Are you okay with that? And I said, okay, yeah. Do I have any choice? No, let's do this. It was cancer-related. I was like, okay, let's do this. Right, I walked out of that office feeling fantastic, guys. I knew I was gonna do this. Yes, forget the plenty times that I failed. Let's do this. Let's do this again. Let's do it. And I did. I spent 6 months doing this project, and I was ecstatic. It was fantastic. I loved it. I loved every part of this project. And I had 5 days left for my deadline. I was early. I had finished early. I thought, all right, let me go and print my work, proofread it, come back, and then I can submit it maybe in the next 2-3 days. I went to print, and I came back, and hey, where's my laptop? It got stolen. That is the luck I had, sadly. I went frantic. I cried. I ran around the entire library looking for my laptop. Maybe my friend was just playing around with me, taking it. Nope. It was gone. It was gone for real. And I had no backup of it whatsoever. It didn't even print. I went into my professor's office, and I cried and I cried, and he just went, okay, okay, what's going on? Oh, by the way, I looked really ugly when I cried. It wasn't a really nice sight. But he looked at me and he said, relax, what's up? And I said, sir, I've lost my laptop. I've got my work on there. He was like, all right, calm down. And I was like, okay. He was like, this has happened to me before when I was doing my PhD. Don't worry, I'm going to find you an extension. You can do this. Huh? For the first time, I have failed again. Terribly. I should have backed that up. But instead of shouting at me, instead of telling me that I did something wrong, there is a teacher in front of me telling me, it's okay. You're going to be fine. We'll fix this together. Wow. I walked away from that office telling myself one thing. I am not going to take that extension. I went home. I spent 4 days until every early morning to every midnight. I finished that six-month project in 4 days, 1 day earlier than the deadline. And I went into his office and I handed it over looking really unattractive. And he looked at me and he said, what is this? I said, this is the thesis that I was supposed to give to you. And he said, are you sure? I said, you know what, sir? Thank you so much for your opportunity. But mark me as equally as everyone else that is supposed to be here with you. And he said, okay. And he did. A couple of months later, I got the grade. I looked at it. And it was the most beautiful thing I had ever seen in my life. It wasn't a fail. I passed gracefully and really well. You know, sometimes bad things do happen in your life. And we spend time and time and time dwelling on it. But not all bad things are bad. I'm glad that laptop got stolen that day, because if that laptop wasn't stolen that day, I would never have known what my strength was. And my strength was research. I thanked my professor and I told him, thank you. I said, I really want to do more. What can I do? Can I take a gap year? Can I do a master's? And he said, no, 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 don't take a gap year. It's fresh in your mind. Do your master's now. I said, okay. I did my master's. I was acing it. Every topic, I was acing it. I was fantastic. Got through it. I got a great grade. I came past it. Then he said, Soozana, there's a position for a PhD in ovarian cancer. It's half funded. You'll have to fund the other half, but you get to work with me. I said, sir, let's do this. And I did. So when I went and told my parents, they were like, let's do this as well. It was really expensive. So for the first year of my PhD, my mom funded me, and it was great. Then she got unwell. That's where my big problem came in. What am I going to do for the money? I've come this far, I can't go back anymore. Right, I'm good at art, I'm artistic. I picked up a camera, and I made that a professional business for the weekend. I became a photographer. I became a wedding photographer. So I would work Monday to Friday at the lab. Saturday and Sunday, I would be Swiss, Germany, Australia, anywhere you name it in the world. I was taking photographs of weddings. I made the money, I paid off my PhD, and I passed it. At the end, I published 3 original scientific articles. I have done 2 postdoctoral positions, and now I'm on my 3rd postdoctoral position, looking at extracellular vesicles in cancer at Oxford Brookes University in Oxford. Is this the girl that failed a lot? Yeah, it is. I failed plenty of times. And you know, when my friend passed away, I never thought I was going to get into cancer. But I feel like she's brought me here. She's brought me to cancer. Cancer specialist in research. If I wanted, I could have failed plenty of times and just let it go. But I didn't know how to give up. I loved my topic so much. I just didn't know how to give up. It's not that I didn't know I wanted to give up. I just didn't know how to give up. I would just restart again and start again and start again. And it was a fantastic time, regardless of the pain I went through. Fail, fail, fail. Teacher walks in. He makes my life perfect. It also reminds you that if you have the right teacher next to you, the right person to recognize your abilities, or the right person to recognize your failures, they will pull you through it. There's a thing in my language, they say, Mata, Pita, Guru, which means before God, it's mum, it's dad, it's teacher. And that's exactly what happened in my life. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for your moment.